Welcome back to another TQA Minute. Today we're going to talk about root cause analysis. Root cause analysis is one of these topics that can and sometimes ought to become very complicated, but through the general day-to-day operations of your business, taking a look at your corrective actions, we need a simple root cause analysis method to help us get from point A to point B so that we can prevent the reoccurrence of the issue. Because after all, that is the entire point of a root cause analysis, is to ensure that you can prevent its reoccurrence. First, let's learn just a little bit about what root cause analysis is. First, it has its history in a practice known as total quality management. Won't go into details here too much, but total quality management evolved from the teachings of the father of quality management, Mr. Edward Deming. Edward Deming developed a process that we still follow today called plan, do, study, act. Today's modern version is plan, do, check, act, because I guess we don't have enough time to study things anymore. We just check them. Any case, the point being, so you take a plan and you take an action, plan, do. The root cause analysis comes into effect when things didn't go according to plan, and you need to learn why they didn't go according to plan. So we study the actions of what happened. And then we take actions to eliminate its reoccurrence and begin the whole cycle again. The idea of a root cause is that we have this nasty little weed of a problem and we have its root. What is the central cause or central causes to the problem? What I would advise you to do, the root cause analysis, is there's a few methods. The first way is this simple. Is you identify all of the various, what we call causal factors that might lead into sustaining that root. Just a causal analysis. The other method is what they call the five whys. And these are my two favorites. Five whys has a much more detailed analysis than this, but the simple version is ask yourself, why did this occur? Ask it again. And do it until finally you have asked for five different times, why did that occur? And why was that the case? And why was that the case? And eventually, you're going to start to dig down into these root causal factors. The combination of these two very simple, very easy to follow solutions is generally what you need.